Now, as we move the section from this point A towards B, we'll encounter a couple at point C. So we take a section towards left of C and then towards right of C. So bending moment towards left of C will be given as VA multiplied by length L by 2 will be the moment caused by this support reaction VA, and it will be anti-clockwise couple. So anti-clockwise couple on the left hand side of section is considered as negative. So we have minus of VA into L by 2. So now we see your VA is negative and is acting downward. So now let me remove this negative sign, since negative sign is used to simply denote that your vertical reaction VA is downward. So we have minus of M by L into L by 2. Now this is equal to minus M by 2. Now we move the section towards right and we take a section slightly towards right of C. So bending moment towards right of C is equal to this moment minus M by 2, the clockwise couple which is acting at the center. Now the clockwise couple on the left hand side of section is considered as positive, so we have plus M. So on solving we get plus M by 2. Now we move this section towards point B. Now bending moment at point B is same as that of bending moment at A, which is 0. This can also be deduced by using the static equilibrium equation, which is the summation of moment at A at B is equal to 0. Our units will be a consistent unit, kilonewton meter and kilonewton meter. Now let's draw the bending moment diagram or bending moment variation diagram. So we have shown our beam as a zero bending moment line. Positive bending moment will be above the line and negative bending moment will be below the line, and along the x-axis we have length of beam. Now since we have the bending moment at A as zero, next since we have bending moment towards the left of C, very near to C, as minus M by 2, so we have bending moment at left of C as minus M by 2. Now as there is no force between the point A and C, so the variation of bending moment between these two points will be a straight inclined line as shown in the figure. Now the bending moment that is slightly towards right of C is plus M by 2. So bending moment from this point changes from negative to plus M by 2. Let me connect these two points by a vertical line, since the value of bending moment is very close to point CU. Now since bending moment at point B is 0, and as we can see there is no force acting between point C and point B, so we have bending moment at point B again as 0, and we connect this point with this point by a straight inclined line. So with this our bending moment diagram is complete. We see that right half part of the bending moment is a positive bending moment and the left half part is the negative bending moment, and the value of maximum bending moment is at point C. It is positive as well as negative. Positive bending moment is a bending moment slightly towards the right of C, whereas negative bending moment is the bending moment which is slightly towards the left of C. So this diagram is called as your bending moment diagram, denoted by BMD. With this, a problem is solved. Thanks for watching in 5 minutes.